We learnt how Indra comes to Karna and asks for his jewels, that is his earrings, and also for the armor. So as Karna was very fond of charity, what he does, he gives it away because he didn't want to hurt anybody. Let's see what happens further. Indra, the king of gods, was filled with surprise and joy. After accepting the gift, he praised Karna as having done what no one else would do, and shamed into generosity, bade Karna ask for any boon he wanted. So now Indra was very happy because being a king and giving away your jewel, that is, being at such high position, you'll have very high ornaments with you, right? So when Indra comes to Karna, he gives it away to Indra. Now Indra is very happy and now he orders Karna, you can ask for any boon. Let's see what is the boon Karna asked for. Karna replied, I desire to get your weapon, the Sakti, which has the power to kill enemies. So Karna will tell, yes, I have one boon, that is, my wish is I want your weapon. And the name of that the weapon had too much of power to kill all the enemies, which is called as Sakti. Indra granted the boon, but with a fateful proviso. So now what he's done, Indra told, your wish will be fulfilled, but on one condition. Let's see what is that condition. Proviso stands for condition. He said, you can use this weapon against but one enemy. He's telling, you can use my weapon, but only for one enemy. And it will kill him, whosoever he may be. But this killing done, this weapon will no longer be available to you, but will return to me. With these words, Indra disappeared. So what Indra does? He'll tell, your boon is fulfilled, your wish is fulfilled. You will use my weapon only to kill one enemy. And once you finish killing that enemy, I will take back the weapon. Let's see what happens now. Karna went to Parasurama and became his disciple by representing to him that he was a Brahmana. He learned from Parasurama the mantra for using the master weapon known as Brahmastra. So now he got the weapon from Indra, and after that he goes to a very holy person who was well versed in all the prayers. He goes to that person and tells him, I am a Brahman. As in Hindu religion, it is told that Brahmins have the highest position, right? So he represents himself as a Brahmana. One day, Parasurama was reclining with the head on Karna's lap when a stinging worm burrowed into Karna's thigh. So what happened? This Parasurama put his head on Karna's lap, and on Karna's thigh, there was a wound. Blood began to flow and the pain was terrible. So now Karna's leg is completely injured and the blood was flowing. But Karna bore it with tremor lest he should disturb the master's sleep. As Parasurama was Karna's master in helping him memorize the prayers, he didn't want to disturb him. So what he did, without shaking the leg, he just started bearing the pain. Here tremor stands for shaking. Parasurama awoke and saw the blood which had poured from the wound. He said, dear pupil, pupil means student, you are not a Brahmana. A Kshatriya alone can remain unmoved under all bodily torments. Tell me the truth. So now the moment Parasurama woke up, he sees the blood and he'll tell that, dear student, tell me the truth, because a Brahmin will never stay quiet if he is injured. It is only the Kshatriya who will remain quiet. So he's telling, why, tell me the truth. What is the truth? And he even also tells that, Parasurama tells Karna that it is only the warrior, the Kshatriya, has the ability to bear the pain. So he is confused if he is really a Brahmin or if he is a Kshatriya. Karna confessed that he had told a lie in presenting himself as a Brahmana and that he was in fact the son of a charioteer. So now Karna confessed the truth. That means he spoke out the truth. He told that, I lied to you telling that I come from a Brahmin family, but indeed I am a son of chariot rider. Charioteer means chariot rider. Parasurama, in his anger, pronounced this curse on him. The moment, see, it was believed in Hindu tradition that Brahmins are the highest and the lower classes are not able to go to the places where Brahmins stay. So now he got very angry. Who? It is Parasurama when he heard the truth. So he took curse Karna. What did he tell? Since you deceived your guru, the Brahmastra you have learned shall fail you at the fated moment. He's telling whatever prayers you've learned will not work with you. It is a curse from me. You will be unable to recall the invocatory mantra when your hour comes. He's telling that when it's time for you to fight with your enemy, when you start reciting the prayer what I've told, it will not work for you. So this was the curse given by his guru to Karna. So this was how the Indra enters in Karna's life. Now let's see about Karna and the grandsire. Grandsire is the old form of telling grandfather. When he learned that Bhishma lay wounded and dying, Karna hurried to the place and fell at his feet and said, when he learned, who is this he? It is Karna. The moment he got to know that Bhishma, the grandfather, was wounded, injured, and he was dying, what he did? He rushed to that place and he also fell at his feet and he started saying few words. See, what are those words? Eldest of the race, Radha's son, who through no fault of his incurred your great displeasure, humbly prostrates himself before you. So he's telling, eldest of the race, Radha's son, I have come to you and I'm prostrating. The meaning of prostrate is to fall down on your knees and place your head on the ground, what we call in Urdu as sajda. Okay. When after humble salutation, Karna stood up, the grandsire greatly moved, tenderly placed his hand on Karna's head and blessed him. So now after he prostrated, the grandfather, what he did? He kept his hand on Karna's head and he started blessing him. He's telling, you are not Radha's son. Young man, he said in loving tones, when Karna told, I am Radha's son and I've come here to prostrate and I've come here to meet and I prostrate you before you, he's telling, I know you're not Radha's son. Indeed, with a loving manner and loving tone, he's telling, you are Kunti Devi's own firstborn. He's telling that your mother is Kunti Devi and you're the first son of Kunti. Narada, here Narada was God sage. He was the musician and storytellers. You don't know how storytellers are. They don't sit and write stories. They write stories only after they travel and have certain experience. So Narada, what he did when he traveled all around, he got to know that Karna was Kunti Devi's first son. So this grandfather is telling Karna about how he got to know. Narada, who knows all the secrets of the world, himself revealed this to me. He's telling, I got to know this from Narada. Son of Surya, truly I entertain no dislike for you. He's telling, you're the son of Surya. Surya means sun. I entertain no dislike for you. There is no dislike for you from my side. But I was grieved to see your increasing hatred of the Pandavas, although they gave you no cause for it. He's telling, I felt sad when you started hating the Pandavas, though they didn't harm you. I know and admire your valor and your open-handedness, and I also know that you belong to the class of Falguna and Krishna in prowess. So he's telling that, I know you and I admire your valor. This means he's telling, I admire your courageous face, and moreover, I know your open-handedness. I know how helpful you are. And I also know that you belong to the class of Falguna. And he's also telling that he knows about his skills, that Karna is very skilled. It is proper that you befriend the Pandavas. So the grandsire, the grandfather Bhishma is telling Karna, I tell you to become friend with the Pandavas. Befriend is to become a friend. Just for the information, Bhishma is the grandfather of Pandavas and Kauravas. As I mentioned in the beginning, Pandavas and Kauravas come from same family. Only the Pandavas are sons of Pandu and Kauravas are sons of elder brother of Pandu. Got it? Dhritarashtra, that is. So now, therein lies the right path for you, who is dear brother. So he's telling it is a good manner for you to become a friend with Pandavas, because they are your brothers. With the closing of my part in this war, may the chapter of your enmity also close. So he's telling, as it is my closing part of this war, I want y'all also to become friends. I don't want this enmity to continue. This is